All right. Well, if you have your Bibles, let's go ahead and open those up. 2 Corinthians 7, verse 1. 2 Corinthians 7, verse 1. And we're looking at the holiness of God. The word holiness in the Greek is hagios. Means to be set apart, to be made whole. We've been talking about and seeing in Scripture how our God is holy, holy, holy. He is whole. There's no spot in Him. He's not broken like you and I are. We saw Peter tell us that we are to be holy as our Father in heaven is holy. That we will have a big nose. Why? Because our Father has a big nose, right? And now we have Paul the Apostle writing the second letter to the church in Corinth. That's a whole nother Bible study in and of itself. But the Corinthian church had a lot of problems. And it's amazing because it's to the church in Corinth that Paul said multiple times, he says, "Do you not know that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit? That God actually lives inside of you." It's to this church in Corinth, and because Paul understood the justification that we have in Christ, that we're just as if we never sinned when we received Jesus, Paul was able to call that church in Corinth. He says, "You guys are saints." Saints, for you that, you know, maybe grew up in a religious system that had saints. Paul says, the child of God, the man or the woman, regardless of how much sin he or she did in the past, that receives Jesus as his Lord and Savior, is a saint, right? Is a saint. So you can go to work today or go tell your spouse, "Listen, my name now is Saint so-and-so." No, don't do that. But that's what we are. But Paul still had to deal with sin and the reality. Listen, you and I desiring to be whole, we want to be holy. Paul tells us we do have a part to play in this. In 2 Corinthians 7, verse 1, he says, "Therefore, having these promises," what are the promises? Listen, we already talked about them, right? God's going to make us holy. God's at work in us. If we want to be holy, we need to behold the Lord, and he will make us holy. We will be holy. We saw Moses go into the presence of the Lord, the tent of meeting. He went and spent time with the Lord. His face came out glowing. He was being made whole. "Therefore, having these promises, beloved," and listen, I love that word, beloved. You'll see it all through Scripture. It literally means be loved, right? Let the Lord love you. You know, I don't know how many of you guys had parents that said, "I love you" as a child, or you even right now, maybe you're in a condition or a circumstance in life and you're going, "I don't know if anyone loves me." Listen, the Lord loves you. He loves you. Jude, Jesus' half-brother, told us in his epistle, he says, "Keep yourself in the love of God." Satan's going, "Come out from under the love of God. Come here, I've got a treat for you," right? And it's foolishness. Be loved. Be loved. "Therefore, having these promises, be loved. Let us cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit, perfecting holiness in the fear of God." Perfecting, or bringing to completion, the wholeness that God wants for us. So how do you and I practically, what part do we play, right? Dad's got the tools. He's doing the job. We're just standing at the side. But there's a little part to play. We can bring him a wrench every now and then, right? What is our part to play in this? Paul tells us, he says, having cleansed ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh and spirit. You know, you and I need to cleanse ourselves from all filthiness of the flesh in spirit. And we need to. You know, I don't know the last time you sat down and had a great meal, right? You sat down, maybe you had some family, some friends, and you just had a great meal. You finished it and you said, "Wow, that was good. Yes, 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 yes." And that's a good thing. Listen, walking with the Lord, enjoying Jesus, going to church, reading your Bible, taking in God's word through these devotions, praying, worshiping Jesus, sharing the gospel. It's like having a great meal. It's good. You go, yes, yes, yes. When you do these things, there's a contentment. Godliness with contentment is great gain. There's a satisfaction that comes with that. But listen, even after a great meal, listen, there's some trash that needs to be thrown out. The garbage gets filled. And you got to now clean up the table. You got to wipe it down. You got to put all the food, the leftovers or whatever, into the trash. You got to tie it up. You got to bring it to the garbage can. Eventually, let the garbage man take it to the dump, right? And it's the same. You know, you and I, even though we're walking with the Lord, there's still some trash. There's still some filthiness, Paul says, of the flesh and even of the spirit, you know. that needs to get thrown out. You know, we can't just let the trash pile up in our house. All of a sudden, you go, man, I'm walking with the Lord. I'm doing the things I need to do. I don't understand. It's starting to stink in here. What's up? Listen, have you taken out the trash lately? You know, are you getting rid of those things? You know, that's why in the Lord's Prayer, Jesus says, pray, you know, forgive me of my sins as I forgive those that sinned against me. You know, empty out the trash. The Bible says if you confess your sins, he's faithful and just to forgive you of your sins and to cleanse you from all unrighteousness. That word cleanse is catheter, like you get in the hospital. It drains you of all the filth, right? You got to take the trash out. And if you want to be whole as your Father in heaven is holy, as Paul says, perfecting holiness in the fear of the Lord, you got to take the trash out. You got to get rid of the filthiness of the flesh and the spirit. And let's ask him to help with that. Father, today we pray, any filthiness of our flesh or of our spirit, Lord, that remains in our lives, we ask, Lord, get it out of us. Empty us, Lord. Change us. Lord, we want more of you, and we want more room for you in our lives. So God, we pray, get what's bad out of our lives, and Lord, all that's good, all the good and perfect gifts that come from above, we want them. So God, we pray, may we deal with the flesh, may we dump out the trash, and may we take in you today, that we may be holy. And God, make us holy, help us to behold your holiness, that we could be holy, and we ask it in Jesus' name, amen.